Good morning. I was wrong about something, so I learned, and I now understand it better. Which is, I want to say awesome, because it is awesome. However, it is also hard.
Flippin' physics.
I recently finally realized that I was incorrect about when the work due to non-conservative forces equals change in mechanical energy equation can be used. This video is not about the physics specifics of that, but rather more generally about learning you were incorrect about something. I have an entire video dedicated to the physics specifics. Okay, so I can trace the genesis of my misunderstanding of the physics back to the fall of 2001. I was in my second year of teaching, and teaching AP Physics B for the first time. Honestly, I felt lucky if I was a week ahead of my students all of that year. I was struggling to keep up with everything associated with being a relatively new teacher and teaching a brand new course with no support system. There was nobody in my high school I could turn to for physics help. I was writing all of my own labs, quizzes, worksheets, homework solutions, worksheets, demonstrations, tests, everything. And I was trying to make sense of this equation, and I made some incorrect assumptions which limited the use of the equation more than necessary. And I had nobody to check with to see if I was correct. I think my error grew out of teaching in isolation. So please, we are way past 2001. But sadly, nowhere near Arthur C. Clarke's vision, but that's a different thing entirely, sorry. Okay. There are so many resources out there. If you have teachers in your building you can get support from, use them. If you are a teacher who can provide support, offer to help. Also, there are so many online communities you can now find that are full of teachers who want to support other teachers. Personally, I find private teacher Facebook groups to be really helpful. I'll put links to the ones I like for physics teachers in the description. Actually, I think this goes for any profession. For the last decade, I have been part of a Slack group of YouTube educators, which has been a great resource for me in this job because, well, I don't know anyone who lives near me that also has this job. So those people have been a great resource for me to troubleshoot specific YouTube educator issues I have had. Also, we need to normalize as a society. That it is okay to admit that you were wrong. It is okay to take in new information and realize that what you thought was correct was incorrect. Yes, it is difficult. Yes, it took me, I think, a couple of years to finally realize I was incorrect. In fact, let me take a moment to personally thank Christopher Beck, Julie Langenbrunner, and Jessica Narkowitz for helping me realize my mistake. Christopher and Julie are part of my quality control team, which means they review my scripts before I film the videos, and they review my edited videos before I post them. They are checking for mistakes and making suggestions, which improves the videos. Jess is helping me with my ultimate review packet and ultimate exam slayer. She performs quality control and writes some of the questions. All three of those people have challenged my restrictions on the use of this equation. So thank you for challenging me, and I'm sorry it took me this long to realize I was in error. Back to my point. We need to normalize that it is okay to admit that you do not understand something. That is learning. Before we can really learn, we need to realize we have something to learn. Do not judge people for their misunderstandings. Do not mock people when they make a mistake. Normalize healthy learning, please. And you have to be kind to yourself. Do not denigrate yourself. Recognize that failing is a major part of learning. You will make mistakes. You will fail, but you will learn. I mean, I've been teaching physics for more than 25 years. I have more than 175,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel, Flipping Physics, and more than 25 million views on this Flipping Physics YouTube channel, which is dedicated to physics education. And clearly, I still have things I can learn about physics, which honestly is pretty cool. I am still learning physics. Creating these videos is a huge learning experience for me. That is why I always end with, thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.